So we're here with Corne from Eco Training. These guys are Indaba professionals. They've been here for the last 10 years. So he's just going to quickly tell us a little bit about what Eco Training does.
Eco Training essentially actually provides training for the lodge industry and then also for individuals wanting to go into the safari industry or become a field guide, as a lot of people know them. So for the American market, that would be the ranger that you encounter when you go on safari somewhere in the bush.
Yep.
And for the South African market, we refer to them as field guides.
Okay, and you do a range of courses, Corne, ranging from kind of 7-day courses all the way up to...
Yeah, all the way up to 1-year courses.
Okay.
I think one of our courses that's very popular is the 1-year course where people get trained in South Africa as well as Botswana as part of that training in about 4 or 5 different reserves.
Okay, you just mentioned two countries there, South Africa and Botswana.
Yeah.
Do you do training in any other places?
Well, we have permanent camps in South Africa, Botswana and in East Africa, but we actually do training in 10 different countries around the world.
Okay, and of these people that come on these courses, have you ever found someone take that knowledge back into the first world and use it to do anything?
Well, actually we have a lot of examples of that, but I think a recent thing that I can just mention is people using the example of a Shongololo, changing it into a new seating arrangement for couches and making a really nice modular design that they've taken from just the inspiration of looking at something very small that other people would have missed.
Oh, fantastic, huh? And Indaba, there's a lot of talk out there that Indaba has become a little bit stale and is not delivering what it should to the stakeholders. I mean, do you agree with that, or do you think it's still a great show?
Well, you know what, I think there's a lot of things that people can maybe point out about Indaba, but I found that it still works for us. We do a lot of business at Indaba, but I think it's about planning, making sure you have the right meetings with the right people, and all of that must be set up way in advance. You can't just pop up at Indaba and then expect things to happen for you.
Okay. Good, so planning's key.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Favorite animal?
Favorite animal? I think actually leopard.
Leopard. That's the second time today. Do you, with regards to your marketing, because you are head of the marketing kind of wing for Eco Training, what forms of marketing are you using? Are you doing the traditional style stuff? Are you getting involved in social media?
We're definitely getting involved in social media. I actually found that about almost 15,000 people visit our website now on a monthly basis, and all of them coming through social media. So it's become a very important strategy for us. I think one of the other things that's always been key to Eco Training is the fact that we write and produce articles for travel magazines across the world, and that's been one of our strongest marketing tools.
Okay, brilliant. Well, thanks very much, Corne, for spending the time with Mamba Media, and we wish you every success with Indaba and for the rest of the year.
To you too.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Cheers.